Well, it's finally the off season, and it's gonna be a long one, a very long one. What's poppin', y'all? It's your man, Cloud Boy Bales, and welcome to another episode of Wisco Sports, where we talk about Wisconsin sports and, of course, Wisconsin sports. The offseason has officially begun for the Green Bay Packers, which means we are in for another wild ride, which is crazy. We're already seeing our special teams coach get fired, thank the Lord. Beck Petton being moved on, and they're looking for new coaching opportunities. And they're up to, I think they're like three people that are really up for the job. Jim Leonard's one of those people. Pretty crazy, huh? 2021. and then, of course, free agency. What's the status of all these players? What's going to happen? And, of course, we're getting ready for the NFL draft, which is in, crazy enough, it's in 2.5 months. I mean, we're really getting to that point already. So that's a crazy thing. So, you know, I want to see what they do for the team's future. That's what's most important. So, anyways, in this video, I'll be discussing my personal preference on the Packers' top five draft needs. Obviously, it's a personal preference. I feel like most people would agree with my top five for positions. But, you know, and this would go towards free agency too, but, and then in the case, you know, of something major happening, I could make another one of these videos close to the draft, but I think this video just describes what positions we really need in this offseason, and I think, you know, we got a long way to go, so it's gonna be interesting. It's gonna be very interesting. So anyways, feel free to subscribe. Comment below, thoughts, predictions, whatever. I'll be making more videos soon with more content, more things, and, you know, departures on the team, signings on the team, who knows. But there'll be more like updates where I just pop up my phone and make a video. So, anyways, hope you enjoy, and let's get to the video. So first up on this list, coming at number five, I have wide receiver. Now, we all remember last year with Aaron Rodgers not having the best year. Everyone thought he was done. Everyone thought he was washed up. He didn't have anyone to throw to. He relied on the running game, you know. You know, and it did work, but, you know, the thing was, a lot of people were worried coming into this year. We weren't going to have any, we didn't draft a wide receiver. What was going to happen? Well, Davante Adams went off. MVS really improved. Lazard became a fan favorite. Tanyan just shows up and does everything for us. And then, you know, I'm impressed, you know, as much as I want a new wide receiver, you know, for the future. Yeah, that could happen. But looking at next year, Davante Adams, if they re-sign Al Lazard, which they should, you got MVS, you got EQ, and then don't forget Devin Funchess. He still hasn't even played a year with us. Obviously, he was supposed to play last year. He opted out, so he still gets another year with us. So most of the wide receivers we have are tall, lengthy guys that can really make the plays that are needed, and the wide receivers that we lack are the short slot guys like Randall Cobb that we had. You know, we thought that we were going to use Tavon Austin in these situations, but he never really did anything for us. And similarly, Taylor's considered a slot guy, but he's special teams. So I'm thinking, you know, maybe we draft a slot guy, maybe in the future rounds. You know, I like Rondell Moore and Tutu Atwell, or some guys like I'm thinking of that could be drafted by us if we draft a good wide receiver by the second or third or fourth round, maybe. And I think it possibly could be a steal, because if you think of it, if Adams leaves, you know, which I think could possibly happen, you know, you're going to need your number one guy for the future of this organization. So maybe this year you draft that guy. possible. Could they even go in the first round with the wide receiver? Possibly. But knowing that there are other positions that I believe are more important for this team's success, I think, you know, Rodgers can make anyone, no matter who they are, a star, because that's how good of a quarterback Rodgers is. We saw Jeff Janis become a star in that one game. We saw all these players, you know, become stars. It's just what happens. Rodgers knows how to play well. And with new wide receivers and new people, I think, you know, it's better to even get one in free agency. That's just my personal opinion. So wide receiver, I think, could be a useful thing for us this year, but definitely next year. That's what I feel. All right, next one on this list was my number one need last year, inside linebacker. I have it ranked at number 4. Now, you know, everyone knows we need guys that can tackle. And, you know, I was hoping that last year we were going to find Blake Martinez replacement and draft safe and eventually do that, you know, and have Kirksey and this new guy be the new guys. And then we drafted Jordan Love instead. But what I didn't know would happen is this random dude, this free agent, would just come in there and become a huge deal, probably the best rookie for our team. If you don't know who I'm talking about, Chris Barnes took over Martinez's spot. He got a lot of playing time, and he did phenomenal for this team. Kirksey, you know, missed a couple games. And you know what? Like, when he was healthy, he was doing really good. And then, you know, but Kirksey and Barnes are great. And then don't forget about Kamal Martin, the other guy we got. Another great guy. Now, as I think of it, if you want to save cap space for, you know, big-name people to re-sign or big-name people to come in, Kirksey's someone you got to let go of. The team, I think, did actually pretty well without him when it came to the stopping the run. And I think Kamal Martin and Chris Barnes, I think they should start. I personally think cutting Kirksey might actually benefit getting a star. That being said, drafting a guy to be depth, he might start because he's super good, but depth is great because if you think of it, you got Barnes, you got Martin, you got this rookie, and then Ty Summers, of course, another guy who's got playing time. You know, no Kirksey, you know, I think can go somewhere else. But drafting another inside linebacker to start or for depth purposes, I think is a great way for the Packers to save money because they trusted rookies, and so far the free agents that they signed just seem to be really doing really good. And, you know, stopping the run has been an issue for the Packers for many years, but you saw in the second half of the season they did a way better job of it. I know there were some touchdowns they allowed because, I mean, they're at the 1 yard line, but, you know, that could really help our case a lot. So, next up on this list, coming in at number 3, I have defensive line. More specifically, defensive end. Now, of course, I know a lot of people believe that this is the first possible choice because of we didn't pressure Brady in the NFC Championship game. Our defensive ends are honestly terrible. I think we all know that. Kenny Clark, you know, he's amazing, but he can't be doing everything by himself. Kiki, he's shown some flashes, and Dean Lowry and Tyler Lancaster just suck. They're always injured. They just suck. And then, of course, Montrevious Adams is a free agent, so bye-bye. Nobody can pressure QBs, and, of course, you got to think of you need a replacement. I mean, it's just pretty obvious at this point. Now, everybody knows they want J.J. Watt to be traded to the Packers. It's very unlikely, and I think it would solve the problem if it happened. But, you know, and if that happened, we'd have J.J. Watt, Kenny Clark, and Kiki. I think that would be fantastic. I mean, really, it would. Now, of course, if Watt's traded somewhere else, which I think would likely happen, you know, if he was reunited with Green Bay in Wisconsin, you know, that would be great. J.J. Watt, you know, he's at the end of his career. Did everything for the city of Houston, probably the greatest Texan ever to play football. I mean, the greatest Houston Texan player ever. That's the best way I could say it. I just love the guy. He's amazing. He's going to be in the Hall of Fame. He's just incredible career, incredible guy, everything. To end the career with his Packers, you know, I think would be amazing. And to trade for him would be amazing. Do I see it happening? No. Just it's not going to happen. So anyways, I think we need a defensive end to draft sometime in the third round. And I think that would totally make sense because someone that is actually really good at pressuring quarterbacks, not someone that can just sit there and do nothing. So anyways, they showed flashes last year. They really did. And I really think that this defense is really up and coming if we have the right pieces. We're this close. But if we want to win an NFC Championship game or a Super Bowl for once, I think, you know, drafting a guy on the defensive end, I think, will definitely fix the situation. All right, next up here, we got offensive line. I think something that, you know, a lot of people know we need, but from what I know, the Packers have really drafted for the future, and I think by getting offensive linemen is something that Goody really probably has on his plate. David Bakhtiari is set to be a Packer for a pretty long time, but everybody else on the line, they're basically, Corey Linsley's a free agent this year, Wagner and all those other guys, Lucas Patrick and Billy Turner, they're all free agents next year, and then Jenkins the year after that. So if you think of it, you know, we need offensive linemen. It's just a priority. And maybe drafting one in the first round or the second round, I think, especially a tackle, that I think is the most important, because Ricky Wagner, you know, he's good. He did some good things for us last year, but you know, he's at the end of his career and people don't really last forever. And then D-Bach also, he won't start probably this year because of the injury that he suffered. I mean, ACL injuries do take a long time to recover. But it's very interesting because I don't know what the heck's going to happen with the line. Who are they going to start at center? If Lindsay's going to resign? I don't know. But from what I know, drafting a guy on the opposite end, I think, is going to help. Now, I know we got those guys from last year. Are they going to be factors? Maybe. Hansen might be a backup center. Stefanik, a backup guard. Runyon, a backup guard. Stefanik, a backup tackle. That's something that might happen. They might even start. They have the flashes. Or maybe we draft one. I think drafting one would make the most sense. Getting a tackle at the opposite end of Bakhtiari and cutting Wagner, I think, is going to save a lot of money. I think getting Ray Wagner and getting a rookie, I think, is definitely going to be excellent. And that way, I think our offensive line could start Bakhtiari, and then if Lindsley doesn't resign, which I doubt he, I don't think he will, unless they try a cheap deal or something, Billy Turner and Lucas Patrick could be the guards, and then Jenkins could be the center, or Patrick could be the center, it doesn't matter. And then the other guy at the opposite end. Or Billy Turner at the opposite end and Wagner doesn't start. I don't know what they're going to do. I don't know. But everybody, I trust the offensive line. I trust what they're doing. But you saw last year, one guy goes down, they don't have a line. I mean, everybody knows that the offensive line is the most important part to really having something. So future picks on offensive line, I think, is a big deal for this team. So finally, the number one need, in my opinion, for the Packers this offseason is a cornerback. Not a quarterback, a cornerback. Everybody knows me, and they know how much I love this guy right here. He is the best cornerback in the NFL, period. He becomes a free agent next year, which means he's going to want that stuff. He's going to want the whole damn bank. I want the Packers to cut players because they need to sign this man. I don't care what they say. This guy is talent. This guy is absolute talent. His coverage status against number one wide receivers last year was incredible. We also got Adrian Amos, Darnell Savage, two safeties who had an outstanding year. Problem is, Kevin King was trash. He's gonna be cut. We need that number two guy. Because, obviously, the number two guy failed to really perfect for the team last year. because they always were the one getting targeted. Because Jaire never really got targeted. The other guys were always the ones that would get targeted, or they throw down the middle. Jenoon Sullivan, you know, he's shown flashes, but you saw his performance in the playoffs. He did terrible. Tremont Williams is old. He'll retire. And then everyone else is just a scrub. Josh Jackson, they don't even play him. So we need a number two corner, especially if Jaire leaves. You think of it, that guy's your number one guy. But if Jaire stays, then that's a huge win for this organization. I mean, seriously. The secondary from years ago, remember our starting corner was Gunter? That guy couldn't cover anything. And then it was like our covers guys were like a banged up Demarius Randall, Quentin Rollins, and Latavius and Haha Clinton Dix. That was our secondary. That was an embarrassment. Our secondary has completely improved from where they were. And I think the secondary can be scary. I know they're one player away from really being a good secondary. And after what I see, I trust Goody. I trust LaFleur. I think they can do it. I think they can really, this is the draft that really they can stand up and say, we got this. And I think, you know, because if you've seen they draft, the people that they end up drafting, they always become stars in their own element. Just like the previous year, Rashawn Gary and Darnell Savage did not break out until their second year. Guarantee a lot of these players in this last year's draft are going to break out because they didn't really get opportunities. For example, A.J. Dillon and Josiah Gadeguara. And then Jordan Love will probably be the backup. So, you know what? People got to get opportunities. That's what matters. So, that's that. So, anyways, long story short, that is my video. It's going to be interesting. Don't know what's going to happen. So, anyways, as I say in every single video of mine, if you like what you see, subscribe below, comment with your thoughts, and share. Because that shows that y'all homies care. I obviously want to get myself out there more. I don't have many subscribers, don't have many things, so I really want to try to. And I'm really struggling, you know, trying to get some people to follow me. So it's just a thing, just a curious thought. But anyways, more content is on the way, and it's going to be a long off season without any football. So hopefully the Brewers, the Bucks, Badgers basketball can really entertain me through these long, sad months without any Packers. All right. Anyways, it's Man Club Boy Bales. Stay safe, be smart, and as always, and forever, go Pack, go. We will see you next time.